The race is on to stop a storm on the surface of the sun from bringing down the internet or knocking out the control system of driverless cars on Earth. Such a solar flare scenario is becoming ever more likely as digital systems get smaller and more vulnerable to the effects of cosmic rays. To try and prevent future problems, scientists in England are using a chip irradiation instrument to test the resilience of electronic devices. The spikes in radiation caused by solar flares happen almost annually and cause bit flips in computer memories, where zeros or ones can be interchanged in the binary code that's critical to the running of every digital device. Dr. Christopher Frost is a scientist at the ISIS Neutron and Muon Source Research Facility in Harwell.
The concern really depends on the device. So one example is memory states. So memory is, of course, vital to electronics. If you think about your computer, it has lots and lots of gigabytes of memory in it. And memory states can be flipped by neutrons interacting with them. In other words, a neutron comes down, hits that memory, hits the bit of silicon in that memory state, and turns a zero into a one or a one into a zero. Everything in our digital world is stored by ones and zeros, so we clearly don't want them changing.
Using the chip IR instrument, Frost and his team simulate the atmospheric spectrum of neutrons that exist at ground level, but at about 1.5 billion times more intense, which allows them to accelerate test electronic devices.
In other words, that we put electronic devices into the beam and effectively run them as if they're in the real environment for about 170,000 years. So 170,000 years represented by 1 hour of testing on our beamline. And in that way, we can find all of the problems that are going to happen in these devices as a result of these neutrons.
NVIDIA and Arm are just two of the companies that have used the instrument to try to make their software more able to cope if or when the next solar superstorm occurs.
There's been a lot in the press over the years about solar flares and a lot of kind of doomsday scenarios. But our job is to make sure that you don't worry about it. Our job is actually for you almost not to notice our work, because what we do is to put the solutions in place, so should there be solar flares, then we've got the systems that are resilient enough to them.